All right, this video is to help your student navigate their Schoology course and resource and access all the resources that are available to them. So when your student first logs into our course, they're going to see the updates page. So it's going to automatically dump them into the updates. I really want them to read all of my updates. I post like 2 a week. And the key here is that they click the Show More button. So you actually can't see the whole update. It's just going to give them a snippet. They need to hit the Show More button and they need to read my latest update because that contains all the pertinent information for the class. If there's something that I really want students to see, I will tag it and make it an announcement at the top so that they really read it. And then sometimes I include highlighted directions, which means the student needs to do something with that update. You can see in these directions, I'm asking students to comment, hit the comment button on this update, and then they can comment thank you and get extra credit. So I want to make sure that they've read these instructions, and that's one way that I receive feedback from your student. After they read the updates, the next thing they're going to do is click on this materials button up here on the left. And when they do that, it's going to look like this. So they're going to see, like I said, maybe an announcement at the top, maybe not, depends on the week. They're going to see their Start Here folder, they're going to see their link for e-tutoring, and then their units. So a lot of students like to use this calendar function on the right, which is really nice because it shows them the pacing guide. So it shows them on Monday, I'm asking them to do the first assignment in Unit 2. On Tuesday, I'm asking them to do the second assignment in Unit 2, and Wednesday, and so on. Now, some students will be tempted to click on the assignments directly from this window, but if they do that, they're missing the lesson. They haven't seen any of the instruction on that particular assignment, and so they often miss a ton of stuff because they haven't learned that material yet. So what they need to do instead is click on these blue folders. So click on the Unit 1 folder, and if you click on Unit 1, they will see this. So you can see in the Unit 1 folder that there are these applications, these little ruler guys that they can click on, and those are the lessons. That's where all of the instruction for their course comes from. I know in an online class it can feel like you're an island and that your student has like no class they're going for, they're not being taught anything, but all of the teaching happens in these lessons. So your student needs to go into the folder and actually click on these lessons. When you click on the lesson, there are 3 different components that are part of the lesson. The first component are videos. So when they open up Lesson 1, for example, they're going to see something like this. There's a video introduction. I actually want them to watch the video. It has quality information for them about the material they're learning for that lesson. They need to click through at the bottom. They'll see a little next button, and then it'll show the next one. All of these little dots on the left will turn solid black instead of open circle when they have viewed those pages. So it's important that your student actually goes through all of the pages. My first line of defense, whenever a student says, I didn't get anything about that assignment, or I only got half credit, or I lost a lot of points, I would say, did you go back and actually work through the lesson? So that would be the first thing to encourage your student to do, is go back and actually work through each page of the lesson. Did they actually watch the videos? Another component of the lesson are practice. So there's instant feedback. Your student has an opportunity to practice problems where they can click on it and they can click hints and they can submit and they'll see in real time whether they're right or wrong. So this is your student's opportunity to practice before they do the actual assignment. There are also check for understanding questions at the end of each lesson. That makes sure that your student has a chance to practice exactly the content for that lesson before they go on to the assignment. So before they're even submitting things to me, they should be doing all of this practice on their own at home. Next, let's say they've done all that lesson and they've submitted their assignment. How do they read my feedback? So to read my feedback, again, on this left-hand bar, they clicked materials before to complete the assignment. Now they need to click on grades. Grades is going to give them an overview that looks something like this. It's going to show them all the assignments that are graded for this course and their score on those assignments so far. I put individualized comments on the right-hand side next to each of those scores, giving the instructions for what they need to do next. So for the check understanding, this person, good to go. This 10 out of 10, I gave them a little welcome message, good to go. This next assignment says if you'd like to make up these points, you can email me and ask for an alternative assignment. So that gave instructions to make up those points. And there are further instructions. Then if a student actually clicks on the individual assignment, they'll see something like this. Each student has 3 submission attempts on each assignment. So their grade is not final when they just submit the assignment. They can actually submit again. So after they submit the very first time, you'll see this little comment bubble, and that means that I wrote individualized comments to your student. So they need to click this blue button called View Assessment, and when they do that, it will look like this. and they can see that they got 0 points on this question. This is what your student wrote. And this is my comment with some helpful tips or questions or instructions to go back to the lesson and get the pieces that they missed. So this is the feedback that I'm providing on every single assignment. Once your student has reworked the problem while looking at my instructions, they can go back to this original submission and they can click on test and quiz. Oops, pardon me. They can click on test and quiz and they can submit another submission of that same assignment. So practice makes permanent, and I want your student to practice until they are perfect. I don't expect them to be perfect the first time, but I do expect them to go back and adjust their work until they're perfect. So they get 3 tries to be perfect. If they try it a second time and they get the same question wrong, obviously my comment wasn't enough for them. That's where I want them to stop and email me. Give me a call, email me. They're not getting it, so go ahead and ask, and I want to make sure I can clarify that concept before they use their third and final attempt. Here are a couple fun facts about your student's math class. I update grades every day except for on the weekends. I will respond to you within 24 hours of your email or phone call, and my favorite way for you to ask for help is screenshotting the problem and then emailing it to me. So screenshot the problem, screenshot the work, or take a picture of the work that you've done so far, send that to me in an email and say, hey, I'm confused, I'm not quite getting this, and I would be happy to respond to you with either a video or a typed out explanation. We can also hop on a video call, we can schedule that, and I can have your students share their screen so that I can see exactly what they're working on. So those are resources available to your student. Thank you.